In this video today, I'm going to show you how you can create a mixed reality recording of a supernatural session in your Quest 2 headset. I have been using a method that is using an iPhone to get mixed reality recordings, but supernatural is not supported with that particular method. So I wanted to come up with a different way of doing it. And so in this method, I'm using a green screen, my Android phone's camera, and Powerdirector19 using my Windows 10 PC. So in this video here, you can see that my iPhone's camera is directly behind the green screen, and I'm standing right in front of it, right behind it. You can't do it at an oblique angle by doing this method because you are going to be overlaying the headset recording of your session. And this is my headset recording. I did an internal recording in my Quest 2 headset as I was playing the game, and I recorded it in the 1024 by 1024 resolution. Okay, now in PowerDirector19, I'm going to take the recording from the headset and I'm going to drag it down to line one of the timeline. I'm leaving lots of space in the front so that I can adjust the position of the different videos relative to each other. Then I'm going to take the green screen recording and drag it right below to line two. So whatever is on line two is going to be overlaying line one. Now for the green screen, I'm going to want to crop out almost everything except for the green screen. So I'm going to make sure that clip is selected. I'm going to come up to Tools, and I am going to Crop Zoom Pan. I'm going to do a freeform, and I'm just going to crop around the green screen like this. Maybe scoot it over a little bit this way. And then click OK. And so now we only have the green screen part showing on the top. So the next thing we're going to want to do is we're going to want to make the green screen portion transparent. So what we're going to do is making sure that the bottom clip is still selected. I'm going to come back to Tools, and I'm going to go to Mask Designer. Next, I'm going to click on this icon right here, and then I'm just going to click around the mask. So I'll start here at the bottom, and I'll just click on the bottom and try and see where that mask is just by doing different clicks, and just click from within the green screen. You can kind of see it overlaid. And then you're going to go to the outside, and click. So what you're trying to do is identify the parts that don't have a green screen. And then you'll close it off by clicking your first dot. Now this one, this point here, I want to click and drag that up because you want to make sure that all of the parts that shouldn't be showing are not going to be showing. So if you want to adjust where your green screen is, you can do it that way. And then you want to invert it. So click this button here to invert it. And you can further adjust it if you want. Okay, and next we'll click OK. We're going to come to Tools again, And we're going to go to PIP Designer. We're going to scroll down until we get to Chroma Key. We're going to select it, use the little eyedropper tool, and select the color. And then with the color range here, we can adjust it down here so that it can do even a little better. And the denoise also, just kind of play around with it. And let's see how that looks, especially when we start to overlay. Okay, so now you can see how that is going to look. So the next thing we're going to want to do is we are going to want to sync up the top with the bottom. And that is probably one of the most difficult parts of this whole process. All right, I'm going to select the bottom clip, and then I'm going to click and drag the person down, maybe make it smaller, try and size it relative to where it is. Then I'm going to find a spot in here where some of the action is taking place. Okay, maybe this needs to be a little bigger. Maybe over this way just a bit. Okay, so now I'm going to try and sync up the top and the bottom. So I'm going to come here to the top clip, and I'm going to find the place where we make the first strike of something. Okay, so this is the point right here. Where we do our first hit. So I'm just going to slice it there so I know where that point is. So I just had my top clip selected. Now on the bottom clip, I want to find the spot where I make my first strike. Temporarily, I'm going to right-click this top one and I'm going to mute it. And so, I'm going to play this until I make my first hit. Okay, and that was right there. And so that's about at this spot. So I'm going to select the bottom clip and I'm going to split it. So now let's move these front portions as far forward as we can. Then I'm going to bring these two together and we'll see how close we got. Okay, so it looks like my movement is in pretty good sync with what we're doing. So let's right-click and unmute the clip on the top. And let's see how that looks.
And a beat, you can move those feet too. Hands stay up.
Okay, now that we have the action synchronized between the top and the bottom clips, I'm going to click and drag the cut portions back here. And I am going to select both of these top clips that I had previously split apart. Then I'm going to right click and I'm going to combine. And then I'm going to do the same thing with the bottom. I'm going to hold down the control key to select both those bottom clips where I split them, right click, and I'm going to combine. So now we have these clips combined, and I am going to select the top clip so that I'm at the very edge. Then I'll select the bottom clip, and I'm going to split it because I don't want this front portion here. So I'm going to just hit the delete key, and I'm going to remove and leave the gap. So now what we've got is the action synchronized with the top and the bottom clip. Okay, and now we no longer need the audio on the bottom clip, so I'm going to right-click on the bottom clip, and I'm going to mute the clip. Now, one thing I've noticed is sometimes when I do the headset recordings, the audio is not synced well. And so we're going to come here. The action is synced well.
Turn these shoulders. Straight, straight, hook.
But the audio is off just a little bit, because you'll notice that the trainer, when he's talking, it's off just a little bit. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this right clip, I'm going to right click on it, and I am going to link, unlink video and audio. So when we listen to it,
losing the upward momentum, coming out of your dust.
So when we listen to the trainer, let's see what happens if we move the audio forward just a little bit. So I find you get better control if you expand the timeline. So I am clicking in this area up here where the ruler is and just clicking and dragging to expand it out to make it less or more sensitive. And then I'm going to take the audio clip and I'm going to click and drag it forward just a little bit. And let's see if we went in the right direction for that. No, I went the wrong direction, so let's click and drag it the other way.
Straight hook, duck up, up. Take me back, cause I wanna stay. See your tears for another day. Lots of lateral motion, keep those feet apart.
Okay, maybe just a little bit more. Let's see how that looks.
Dock it up, dock it up, dock it up, up, block.
Okay, and so that looks pretty good audio-wise. And if we move it to the far front here, you can see how far we had to move the audio to get it synced. Okay, and now I'm going to identify the portion in the audio or the portion in the video that I'm going to want to start my video. And so let's take a look. Okay, so maybe about right here. So I'm going to, I don't have either of the clips selected, and then I'm going to split the timeline. And what that's going to do is it's going to split them both at the same time. And so let's see if this is where we want the beginning of our video.
Orthodox dance in Iceland. And a beat, you can move those feet too. Hands stay up.
I saw you dancing in a crowded room. You look so happy when I'm not with you. But then you saw me, caught you by surprise.
Turn these shoulders. Straight, hook.
Okay, now one thing I've noticed is the green screen is cutting out a little bit of my head here. No, I want to make sure I'm at the beginning of my clip. So I'm going to get rid of the front of the clips here that I didn't want. So I'm going to delete all of these and move it to the very front of my timeline. So this is where I want my video to begin. I'm going to right click here and I am going to remove and move all time clips after the removed gap so that everything is moved to this area. So now I know I'm at the very beginning. So I'm going to select the bottom clip. Let's come up to Tools, Pip Designer. And we'll scroll down to the chroma key and I'm going to reduce that maybe a little. And actually let's go to where we've got some here. So I'm going to go to the very beginning of where we really need it. And I want to fix up this area here. So I'm going to select my bottom, Tools, Pip Designer. And I'm going to scroll down to chroma key. Let's try the denoise first. Okay, yeah, I had too much of denoise. So maybe about like that. That looks much better. Okay, so now let's see what we're looking like.
Orthodox stance in Iceland. And a bead. You can move those feet too. Can't stay up.
I saw you dancing in a crowded room. You look so happy when I'm not with you.
Okay, now one thing I may want to do is I'm going to select the bottom clip again. And I'm going to maybe make this a little bit bigger and move it just a little over further that way. And see if I like that position better.
Turn these shoulders. Up. Straight, hook. Duck, up. Using the upward momentum. Coming out of your duck.
Okay, and I may actually make it a little smaller. Just a tad bit smaller. And let's see what that looks like.
Lateral motion. Keep those feet apart.
Okay, maybe I want to move it over just a titch that way. And let's see what that looks like. Okay, that duck looks better.
Duck it up, block. Stop, pop, dance.
Okay, so that part looks pretty good. I'm pretty happy with that. Now, I also recorded a session with the bats. And so let's make sure that everything is still looking okay here. So we'll look here and see if we need to adjust anything. Now, one thing I've noticed is there's a bit of the green screen mask here that's showing through. So I'm going to select that bottom clip again, come up to Tools, Mask Designer, and let's bring down the middle part a little more like that. And let's bring this in a little bit here so that it's totally within the green screen. And you can see that looks much better now. And so let's see how this portrait looks.
All right now, immediate side-to-side action.
Thought I'd end up with shine, but it wasn't a match.
Let's breathe through. And reach these bonds too.
Okay, I like how that is looking too. So now what we're going to do is I had two different sessions here. I had a boxing session, so I want to find the end of that, which is probably about right here. Okay, so back it up a little bit.
Back.
Okay, and I'm just before this comes up, I'm going to frame back, and about right there, I'm going to slice. Now let's find the beginning of the next session, which is here. And once again, I can see right here, there's a bit of my mask showing through. So I'm going to select this bottom one again, go to Tools, Mask Designer, and let's move that down a bit, and then we'll go OK, and that has taken away that little piece. Okay, and at this point, I'm going to do another slice. Well, actually, let's make sure that everything is selected here. So I'm going to hold down my control key and make sure everything is selected before I do my slice. And everything in between I want to get rid of. So I'm going to hit delete, remove and fill gap. And when I do this last clip, when I do the remove, fill gap and move all clips, it's going to move it all together. So now let's go to the very beginning. And let's see what this is going to look like. And you see the mask here. I need to fix the mask again. So I'm going to select the bottom one, Tools, Mask Designer. And it's best to make these adjustments to the mask at the very beginning instead of in the middle like I did, because all it did is added a keyframe in those areas where I adjusted. So it's always best to be at the very beginning when you make these adjustments. So I am going to click OK, and you'll notice those little marks now are gone. And so let's see what this looks like. Okay, and I'll just click the play.
Orthodox dance in Iceland. And a beat, you can move those feet too. Hands stay up.
Okay, and now we'll look and see the transition between the two clips. So this is the end of the boxing clip.
But I want all your energy in this last track. All right now, immediate side to side action.
Okay, I like this. You can play around with this bottom clip by changing the size and position of the person so that it's as good as you can get it. And then at this back here, let's see where we want to end our clip. And so probably just before the end results come out. And then I will just trim it here. And then we can get rid of all, whoops, I didn't want to do that. Undo that. Let's make sure they're all trimmed. And then I'll hit the delete key to get rid of those. And so this is where the clip will end.
Let's hold on to that gratitude by saying thank you and keeping our spirit up for the next.
And so once you're satisfied with your clips, then you can produce it. And I have a preset for my Quest 2 headset. And what that is for the video, it's just doing a 1080 by 1080. It doesn't have a 1024 by 1024, so the closest is 1080 by 1080. And then the 30 frames and progressive, I just use the defaults for the rest of the settings, including the audio. You name it what you want to name it, and then just press start, and that will produce your mixed media video. And I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye!